Hey, look.
Look at this.
Woo! Here we go. Hey, it's Larry Hryb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Guess what? This is the Major Nelson Radio Hype Zone. We only have three people left with me. Jeff Rubenstein. Jeff sitting over here to my right. Hey. Your left, my right. And then the man himself, gamer boss in charge of Rare Studios, Craig Duncan.
Hey. It's a pleasure.
Good to see you, Craig. Here we are.
Always fun to do this.
The pin game is very strong.
Yeah, there's a couple of special pins there, for sure.
We are here, going to hang out with you guys for a while, drop some stuff in the chat. We're going to be giving stuff away, so I'm not going to say it now, but...
Grab your controllers.
You're going to need your controller a little bit later on, because we're going to give some stuff away. We've got some interactivity going on. But we're excited to be down here. We're on the show floor. Jeff and I were just talking backstage, and actually, you can help us with this.
Okay.
Between the three of us, I think this is like our 40th E3. Because I've been to 17 or 18.
I'm like 10, 12,
right.
Maybe.
Yeah, yeah, I'm at a dozen. Yep. I've been coming since E3.
So there we go.
Yeah. So many.
Do you remember what was your first E3, Craig?
I think 2003.
Right, so I was 2003 as well.
Yeah,
so that's...
and then I missed a few. I think when you're a game maker, you kind of come when you've got a reason to come.
Right.
And there's a few when you're mid-cycle that you're not demoing. So, but I mean, it's been the last five on the bounce. So.
Right.
Yeah, I love it here.
And then yours was when?
2007. The very first event I went to anywhere was the Xbox briefing in a high school. It was like in a... Santa Monica High School, which, as high schools go, it's pretty amazing. Robert Downey Jr. went there. This isn't like Sweet Valley High or something. They had an amphitheater and a swimming pool and all kinds of stuff. Anyway, and I remember, and I'm so embarrassed now, it's going to go right to your head. Twitter was pretty new at that time.
Right.
And one of the very first tweets I ever did was like, oh my God, I just saw Major Nelson.
Well, let me tell you a funny story. I believe I invited you. Didn't I invite you to that one?
We had talked.
Right. Anyway, enough about that.
Oh my God, I'm so embarrassed.
Anyway, we're excited to be here. I mean, this is great. We're in the South Hall, mixer booth. Of course, the Xbox Theater, which is a massive theater, is over about 500 feet in that direction. That's where we had our briefing on Sunday. We're going to take a moment and talk about the briefing because that was...
I think it went pretty well.
I think you liked it.
Yeah.
I think you really liked it. The briefing was so big. It was so crazy. Craig, I want to talk to you about... You guys had something in the briefing.
We did. We had two things in the briefing.
Two?
And then obviously the Rare logo on Phil's awesome first-party studios.
We're going to talk about that later on in the show, all the great the portfolio.
Which gave me goosebumps, even though I kind of knew about it, but it still gave me goosebumps. So we showed Sea of Thieves, the next two content updates that come in.
Right.
And then right at the end of the briefing, in the last third, we had a little tease of a classic Rare IP, Battletoads.
Right.
Which was, I think, surprised everyone, but the reaction...
Including me. I know. I'm like, what is this? No.
Right.
No.
Yep.
That was so cool. Yeah.
So my favorite was the non-specific feature declaration.
Yeah.
Which is kind of game developer speak for exactly that. Yeah. It's like, we're going to do something, but we really don't know what we're going to do. And here it is.
Yeah. This thing's early. I mean, really early announcement. It was definitely a tease. We wanted to tease in trailer. So... Quick origin story. So AJ runs a team in the UK called Dalala Studios, is the biggest Battletoads fan on the planet.
Like, really?
Literally every single time. I've known him for about 6-7 years. And they came out with this amazing Battletoads pitch, brand new game, and so passionate, such fans of the franchise and IP, and we couldn't say no. Like it was that good. So we're working with them,
right?
And we'll show more soon. Like,
do we? I think we may. I think the truck may have the trailer. I mean, we can
a
if we can show it and we'll talk
passed.
Over it. If you do, you don't.
Oh, right. Look at that!
So here it is. So this is what in the audience on Sunday. This is what they saw.
And nobody had any clue. Like you see the comic book fonts.
I had the team from Dalala sitting next to me,
right,
in the briefing. So think about it from their point of view. So we invite them over. They're sitting here. They're watching. Yeah, their dream project be announced on the biggest stage at E3. Obviously the bikes and the turbo tunnel was a classic level that people recognize. Then we announced the Toads.
Right, there it is.
And
then the crowd goes crazy.
Yep. Absolutely.
Please tell them to put an easy mode in for me.
We've talked about things. So that was
going to have body morphing genre mashups. Three-player couch co-op, 4K, hand-drawn 2.5D graphics, and
broad, non-specific feature decoration.
We should have got Larry to do the VO.
Well, the weirdest thing is, I was. This is great, coming in 2019. The weirdest thing is, I'm watching this, I'm like, Rare is a UK studio, yet they're using an English announcer, and all the US studios use an English. I mean, it was reversed.
You know this at this point, but here in America, if you have an English accent, we just believe you.
Yeah.
It's true. You're either the bad guy in a space movie,
right? Yep.
Or you're selling us something and we're just nodding along.
Yes. That's why Rare gets so much love in Redmond whenever I go visit. So I just, yeah. It's great.
But anyway, it's great too. It's great. Thank you for joining us. That's fun. Yeah. And of course, Sea of Thieves. I was last out at this. So this is a funny story. I haven't told this before. I was last out at Rare in the studio in February, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Right before you guys launched.
A little bit cold.
And it was a little bit cold. And I remember we're going through, because Rare is a series of barns. And Craig's like, okay, this is where we're doing the PC. And I went up and sat with Ted Timmons, who's the PC lead for a while, and walking through and talking to everybody. And then I'm like, well, what's over there? He says, I can't show you. So I'm seriously, he would not let me in this area because they're working on probably Battletoads and other stuff too. So
yeah, I mean we've always got things going on, secret things. But the other thing as well is we did big Sea of Thieves announcements and next two content updates.
Look at this right here, is your Sea of Thieves. 91 million hours played. Yeah. There he is, that shark. Megalodon, sorry.
And I think what's interesting is like we're talking about a game in the E3 briefing that we launched 10 weeks ago.
Right.
So, and this was sort of interesting for us this year. So, our trailer really was a little bit of like, here's what's happened since we've launched. Great launch.
Right.
Over 4 million players. Yeah, my favorite stat, 1.5 million Xbox Live friendships made on the seas.
Right.
And then it was really like, here's a glimpse of the next two content updates. Here's what's coming in July with the Cursed Sails. No. And further on than that, here's the Forsaken Shores coming in September. And we released a blog post I'd encourage everyone to read. Tells you a little bit more about what's in those updates.
Right.
And literally, I've been talking the whole time here to fans and press and media. And unlike last year, where we were explaining to everyone what Sea of Thieves was,
right.
This year they've all been telling me their Sea of Thieves stories. It's been wonderful.
Well, we've got a lot of them. Of course, we have the chat up here. We're watching the chat. Question from the chat was, look at this. This looks great. Jeffrey, where did you get those shoes? Can we get a close-up? I don't know if we can get down to these shoes. There was a question about these lovely shoes down here. So, Jeff, what's going on here?
These are Air Jordan 1s.
From 1985.
Scuffed that. Apologies for that one.
All right, so.
And you don't tie them.
You don't. Yeah, Jeff, I actually have a pair. I wore them yesterday.
And you tied them.
And I tied them, and I was chastised accordingly.
Were you going to be playing basketball on them?
I was doing a quick pickup game out on the side with the guys on
you
the
got
dock.
Standards.
All right?
Yep.
Anyway, so, Craig, it's a great show. I want to talk about, you alluded to it a little earlier. I want to talk about the new studios.
Our friends.
You guys are in the UK, and all of a sudden, the Xbox, the first part of UK studios, it's tripled.
Yes.
Let's talk about that.
Yeah, I mean, I had goosebumps when Phil made the announcement, and, you know, obviously a lot of work goes into these kind of things. And, Nina and the team at Ninja Theory, and to me, like, awesome people, great developers, you know, great reaction when the studio got announced. Playground Games, I mean, I think as Phil said it, you know, the highest rated studio this generation.
Yep.
You know, Gavin, Ralph, Trevor, the team there, Alan, do an amazing job. You know, them and Turn 10, they're like this awesome jigsaw that dovetails together that just
perfectly
makes
it's like
makes
yin
awesome.
And yang, isn't it?
Incredible.
Yeah.
You know, Compulsion Games, Guillaume and team over in Montreal, great friends of mine as well, which is lovely to have Guillaume as part of the family. And you know, Daryl Gallagher's new studio
down here in Santa Monica.
Yep.
Yeah, just it's incredible. Like,
yeah.
Just the way it was revealed, where
do we have that slide? I'd love to put that slide up here.
And as Phil started. To, you know, you talked about first. I think you talked about Undead Labs.
Yep.
And
of course, yeah.
Daryl Studio. And
the guys Undead.
And then
you
just saw the box, and it was like, there's room for more boxes.
There's more.
Yeah. And you're just like, as soon as it would cut back to him, like everyone in the crowd was like, and then the pop for Ninja Theory.
Right.
In the crowd.
Now I got to tell you, because I have been talking about Ninja Theory for some time, and I played the game, and I'm a huge, you guys, because of radio, I'm a huge audio fan. So when I played Hellblade and I was getting the binaural audio, and look out behind you, it is a game, I urge Incredible. You. If, now, this is a disturbing game. It can be.
Did you get a chance to play Hellblade?
Absolutely.
But go play the game. It is phenomenal. I'm so excited to work with that team. I'm a fanboy. I mean, all the studios, I'm a fanboy because I'm a gamer, but I'm so excited they're going to work with you. And I even talked to Ralph, and I even came to you.
Yep.
Because I said, Craig, where is Playground Games relative to you guys? Where are they? Their studio?
Yeah, so Playground Games are in Leamington Spa, so they're about 45 minutes away from Rare.
Right.
We know the team super well. We've worked with them a ton over the years. Ninja Theory over in Cambridge.
Yep.
So
2 hours away.
Yeah, 2 hours sort of towards the southeast, I guess. Yeah.
But more importantly, we were showing the latest Forza Horizon, and I came up to Craig after I saw it, and I said, Craig, and I'm gonna go. I told Ralph this as well. I said, we're going through the UK. You're driving. You see the seasons are changing. The leaves are coming down. I said, I want to go on to your football pitch at Rare Studios and go do donuts out there. I want to crash through the lobby at Rare and out the back.
I wrote it down. I'll speak to them when I get back. We'll see. Red DLC.
At GamerBoss on Twitter, tell him you want that. Okay, he can ask for it, but it's up to the guys at Playground.
Yeah, of course.
Well, and one thing that they got right already, because I've been lucky enough to visit Rare, Sheep. Like, in the demo, in the E3 demo, at one point you're going through some country
lane. And there's sheep.
187 miles an hour. They're getting out of the way.
There was a lot of wildlife in our E3 briefing, wasn't there? There was a few deer.
Well, we had space rhinos and space deer.
Yeah.
Well, I think
look at this right here.
The sheep. But
now, did you recognize some of these areas, Craig? Because you live, obviously, in the UK.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, kudos to the Playground team and the great artwork and representation they do. I mean, that countryside looks like the countryside, actually.
Right. I remember going out to see you guys, and this, I feel like, you, he picked us up in his car. And
His McLaren Senna?
He's full. No, we didn't have any room in that.
No trunk space.
I remember going through here, and I'm like, this is exactly what it looks like.
And we have snow.
Yeah. This is just stunning. If you get a chance, if you're here at E3, you can actually play it over at the Microsoft Theater. You can get your hands on, right?
You get to play through all four seasons a little bit here and there. Yep. You get to play with the Senna,
right,
which goes so fast.
Now, I was just looking at the chat. There was a request. Xbox Pope wants to see a Rare track. What would that look like?
A Rare track?
Yeah.
Well, Horizon's all open world, isn't it?
Right. I'm sorry. Justine is over here. Yeah. Come over here, sweetie. Come over here. Come over here. Come on up. No, come on up. I need you to come up here. For those of you that don't know, this is
we are going live on. Now.
This is Justine.
How are you? I just crashed the stream.
No, you come over here, sweetie.
We're live. Joking about crashing the stream.
And can you talk in over here now? Now, I was talking to you on Twitter because you just got a flamethrower. Where is it?
Not here.
I didn't think they would let you come in with
it. No, it's very dangerous.
You having a good time?
I'm having so much fun.
You need to get over to the Xbox area and take a look. Justine, ladies and gentlemen. You must love her. So, all right. We'll catch up after the show. Thank you for crashing. Okay. Flamethrower party. All right. You never know who you're going to run into when you're here at E3. I mean, they're just people are just walking around.
That's how it works.
It's a funny story. I was in my hotel. And I was on my way down. I don't think I told you this. I was on my way down, and in the hallway going down to the elevator, I run into Todd Howard in the hotel room slippers.
You got to relax.
Yeah, you got to relax. Even Todd has to relax. And then
you
I ran
into a very
into,
busy day or I, a very busy E3.
I ran into who else did I run into? I ran into Sam Lake.
Oh yeah,
from Remedy Games. Remedy showed a great game over on the PlayStation, and it was coming to Xbox.
Yeah, Control.
Not exclusive. Coming to Xbox. And then speaking of PlayStation, I ran into Reggie because now you can play Fortnite. That's my segue.
It was a lot. It was like a
slide this chair.
That was like a Forza Horizon drift segue, wasn't it?
Yeah. Woo! Breeze got a little chillier all
right.
of a sudden. Anyway, back on track here.
Yeah.
Have you gotten to see, obviously you've been very busy.
Yep.
You have a really cool Sea of Thieves, you brought the pub to E3.
Yeah, we obviously because we've launched already. Yeah. We actually had a debate in the studio about bringing playable to E3.
Yeah,
right.
And then we're like, and people have come and asked on the show floor, like, hey, can I play Sea of Thieves? And it's like, yeah, you can go play it at home. and you know, you can just go download a Game Pass trial and you can play
for $1.
Game Pass.
Go play it tonight.
Game Pass is extraordinary. It's been so good for you guys.
It's been incredible. I mean, maybe my services and operations engineers might disagree because we obviously have way more people, and you know, good problem to have. Yeah, great launch. You know, I think we announced 4 million players. We're over that now. That was a couple.
Really? Oh, wow.
And just, you know, for us, having people come and play Sea of Thieves however they play. They come in, if they subscribe to Game Pass, that's awesome. If they buy the game and that's what they want to do, that's awesome. So, yeah, for a multiplayer game, new IP, just the scale we achieved. And Game Pass was a big part of that.
And right. Yeah, and I think a lot more people, as they see like the Curse sales drop, and you've got stuff coming this summer, you've already announced stuff coming in the fall.
Absolutely. Great. You know what I want to do now? I'm sorry, I don't want to interrupt you,
no,
but I'm going
to.
Show. No, this is our show.
My name on it.
I'm going to give the cue. I have to say these specific magic words to get things going. We're talking about Game Pass. I would like to give away a month of Game Pass, so right, and a month of Xbox Live. So get those controllers warmed up. It's time for trivia.
Oh, here it comes.
All right, and today we are going to do, the prize is 30 days of a Game Pass. You can try out all the games.
Question.
All you can eat.
What late night television show did Larry get his name Major Nelson from?
Oh.
I don't know this.
Oh, I know this one.
A, I Love Lucy. B, Leave It to Beaver. C, I Dream of Jeannie. D, Golden Girls. Who wrote this? Time's
up. All right.
The correct answer is, I think we're going to see it up here. The answer is, most people did get it, didn't they?
That's good.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Although a lot of people thought it was Leave It to Beaver.
Yeah, well, it's just, gee, Wally, why do you think that is?
I have
and,
no
and
idea.
The character Major Nelson was like the guy who owned the genie lamp.
It was the astronauts.
Yeah,
there you go. I to be honest with you, I didn't know we were going to ask that question, so there it goes. Anyway. Well, I don't know. We're gonna catch up with you. We're gonna DM you the code and whatnot a little bit later on after the show. So we're gonna do that after the show. We'll get
all right,
you a Game Pass.
We're at the show. What have you gotten to play at the show?
Well,
what's been good? What have you seen?
Lots of people I know. It's
a social game.
It's absolutely a working and social game. I mean, you mentioned Forza Horizon. Did you see the hydraulic rigs?
Yeah.
Yes.
So, like, seeing people on those, they were having an absolute blast.
I actually asked them if they could take that hydraulic rig, and I said, could you hook it up to Sea of Thieves for me so I can get going in the boat?
Oh. Somebody told me a story from last E3. They had partied too hard the night before.
Right.
And then they came to play, and immediately they're staring at you couldn't get, if you sit close enough to your TV, you have a big enough TV, you're on the prow of the ship.
Yeah, it's pretty,
You need Dramamine, yeah.
Now I want to tell you something. This is actually really interesting. One of the biggest reveals we had at the Xbox briefing was at the very end when Phil Spencer got cut off by a DOS prompt. And then people were like, wait a minute, what just went wrong? You know, because we've all seen everybody take those screenshots in the airport of the DOS and the blue screen of death. Everybody thought things went sideways. Cyberpunk 2077. You had the chance to go see this exclusive demo.
I've seen an hour.
I want you to tell us what you saw, Jeff.
I snuck my way in yesterday, and my mind was blown. So, what's the best way I can
look at this?
There is nothing like this game that I've seen. I'd say the closest thing that it evoked to me was Deus Ex, the most recent Deus Ex since Human Revolution and Mankind Divided, which I really love. But in an RPG form, less of a stealth sort of game, but very reminiscent in that your actions affect the world, very reminiscent in that there are many ways to tackle how you're going to go into a particular space, but there's also a tremendous amount of character creation. They showed us a little bit of the character creator. You pick their backstory, you pick their appearance. The game looks beautiful. You have your own apartment. It's a first-person game. A couple people were like, what? It's in first person? And it actually makes a ton of sense.
Yeah.
So in this world, they were, the character goes to like a sort of the type of doctor that they have. Everyone's implanted. It takes place in an alternate future. And people have really augmented themselves. Again, you know, we've seen...
Much like L.A.
And it takes place actually in Northern California, at least the demo that we saw in a place called Midnight City, I believe. And at one point, the character got an upgraded eye. And then it made sense. First person, all of a sudden, they can look at someone and they can see how well-armed they are.
Right.
What kind of threat they were. There's so much to this game. I mean, those of us who played The Witcher 3, I know you have one of my favorite games ever.
Right.
And to think that a team like this and the attention to detail, you never did the same thing twice in
right.
that game.
Right.
And so knowing that they're going to take that and apply it to an entirely different environment.
A new world.
Yeah. And, but the world building.
Yeah.
You know, like immediately this world felt lived in.
Yeah.
And there was one scene when you came out of your apartment and you see the city, and it was sort of, it reminded me a little bit of Shibuya Crossing in Tokyo.
Which is a big famous where the two roads are going
by. Yeah, it's a crazy mixer of an intersection. And it was kind of like that, and there were so many people, everyone looked different. Everyone was walking different. They were talking to each other.
Right.
They were
going about their business. It was living and breathing.
And you really felt that.
Right.
And I am so excited for this.
That was awesome.
Yeah, anyways. At the end of the demo, they give you a comment card, like, what did you like, what did you not like? The thing I wrote that I didn't like is, I can't play this now. That's my biggest complaint, is I can't play it now. But Cyberpunk 2077, keep your eye on it. It is going to be something else.
And it is going to look, if you are lucky enough to own an Xbox One X, it's going to look beautiful. It's going to make your eyes melt. So.
And you can fix that with a mod in the game.
Yes, you can fix that. Exactly. That's the way the game works. So.
Go down to the doctor. Yeah.
So we saw that. I mean, we're talking about what we've seen at the game. Now, it's interesting, to your point, you know, every time I go into the Xbox booth, I go downstairs in the Sea of Thieves. You guys have recreated the tavern.
We have.
You have the tavern, and Craig is there. I mean, this is one of the hardest working guys in the game industry. I go down there, you and your team, you've got tattoos.
We went for a more experiential thing. So what we've been doing is we've been doing a ton of kind of player fans of Sea of Thieves meet and greet.
Right.
So we've got a great big tavern table, and we've literally been inviting small groups, 6 to 8 people to come that have played Sea of Thieves to meet with the team, and we're just chatting.
Did you see what I called it, right?
The tavern.
No, you know, with the table where you have everybody, I called it the pirate picnic.
Because
there's like it's a picnic table, and you've got your development team, and fans are just sitting around and having a great time.
Yeah, and we're just chatting. You know, the great thing about these events is you get to meet people and get great feedback and talk to them about what people like and what what ideas for the future people have. And we've done tattoos, which I should have got one knowing I was coming on here. We've got a lot of Sea of Thieves merchandising. We're just having great fun with our Sea of Thieves community. And E3 is a great chance to meet them. And we've met people from all over the world.
And a great chance to listen. And
absolutely.
I feel like your team is more than, now obviously, everyone in this industry has they're really drawn in there with the fans.
Right.
But I feel like Rare does go another step.
It's really important with a game like Sea of Thieves where player psychology and motivations and how people play and how people play together. I think I read a quote from one of the journalists who said it's like you've created this friendship-making social experiment.
Yeah,
right.
And it's really interesting to hear from players firsthand. Like we did our first content update, The Hunger in Deep, and to hear players go, it fundamentally changed how we interacted when we met other crews, because we went and met other crews. Did the Hunger in Deep.
You're no longer adversaries. You have to work together.
Yeah, you go work together, and then they go on and do a skeleton fort, or they go on and drink in the tavern and go and make friends. And actually, I just literally read an email from the team with some data on that. And we, through our telemetry, we say, hey, when ships get in proximity, how often does it result in a ship battle?
Right.
And introducing the Hunger in Deep, the ships that got into proximity to battle that didn't, reduced by 50%.
Oh, interesting.
So we've basically made Sea of Thieves twice as friendly by introducing a massive prehistoric shark.
Phenomenal.
But it's that kind of stuff. And what you hear players say is, hey, it was, I had an amazing experience like I've never had. We met some great people. We went and did this great adventure together. And now I've got more friends to play with.
Right.
And now you're just going to be layering more and more.
And everything we add in, just gives more and more ingredients.
Yep. There it is. See, it's big fit. Thank you. Unprompted. Now, I would like to point out is if you look at Craig, if we can get a shot of Craig, he's got this lovely T-shirt on. Now, you can't buy that T-shirt, but if you go to gear.xbox.com, they have the gold version of that.
Yeah, and we've in our Xbox stand, I think I tweeted a picture of it, we've got a kind of merch cabinet as well.
Yep.
And actually taking a lot of the lead from the Minecraft team that do it.
Oh, boy.
Such an amazing job with just Minecraft stuff.
Right.
And yeah, you know, we've got plushies, t-shirts, and all that stuff, you know, just for people that really love the Sea of Thieves world and the characters, like, it's great. So lots of that for show, and some of it on sale, I think, shop.seaofthieves.com. And, you know, for us, it's not something we do to go make a lot of money. Like, I think it's actually pretty cost neutral for us.
Right.
But it's just great.
It's fun.
I mean, I love wearing the stuff I care about. I mean,
all
got
the time.
A great Gears t-shirt on.
Yeah. So it's awesome. Actually, we should talk about Gears.
Should we?
I feel like we should.
Finally. Well, we will. We're going to talk about it in just a minute. But first, get those controllers warmed up.
It's time
for the next trivia question. Today, we're going to be playing for another 30 days of Xbox Live Game Pass, or Xbox Game Pass and Xbox Gold. So here we go. Ready? All right, the question is, which episode is the very first, is the very main, what is this? Which episode is this? I can't even read it. So is it 622, 615, 630, 619? I don't even know, but you're going to tell us. Grab those controllers right now. Press the button, and the answer is time's up. Of course, this is probably, everyone should get this one because the web is your friend. The correct answer is...
Savage question.
Savage question. We lost half of it. Whoa. All right.
You know, all these game show references are completely lost on me, right?
Really?
You don't have HQ over there?
No.
Oh.
Well,
someone somewhere is laughing. Maybe it's not Scott. Yeah. Anyway, I want to talk about Gears of War 5. Now, Jeff teased it months ago.
I didn't hear about that. That was...
So at Inside Xbox, the second one.
Look at it right here.
Yeah, I was wearing an Undefeated T-shirt, and their logo is basically like the hash marks.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's 5, and I had the gear. That shirt's like 3 years old. And
the internet thought he was.
All of a sudden, my phone was blowing up during the show.
Oh my god!
Like, are you? And I was like, oh my god, what have I done?
Yeah.
What a beautiful game, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think Cage is great, and look at these environments.
I talked to Eugene Bird.
Yep.
He was here. He was in their briefing. Here they are together. Kate and Eugene. It's such a beautiful game. But the fun part about this was the reveal, because you saw
the Omen.
In the theater, and of course everyone watching it in beautiful 4K at home on Mixer. They saw the beautiful Crimson Omen open up, and then.
But what if it's not? You heard a buzz.
And then, I don't know if we can play it here, but then pop through was these little characters.
Yeah,
Funko. The Funko.
But in the room, though.
Right.
Literally, the Crimson Omen comes up, and everyone's just like, oh my god. Like,
right. Yep.
And then you almost heard an audible gasp.
Yeah, you're like,
pop character. Everyone's just like,
Okay.
So does that mean Rod has trolled the entire world?
Oh, yeah, he did. Because I think the original order of it was backwards.
Right,
I think Gears 5 was the original, going to show that. And then the RTS. Here it is.
Not RTS. Gears Tactics.
Okay.
We'll talk more about that.
Right.
Very into that.
So there was that. And then we had the. But anyway, so it was just a huge troll. Because you're right. In the audience, of course, everybody online was going, yay, Nukia giving us a mobile game. No! Strategy game. No! Gears of War 5. Cool.
Okay. So Gears Tactics.
I am super excited about that.
Thank you.
I love XCOM.
XCOM is one of the best games.
And that was the vibe I got looking
right.
at it.
Yeah. And I've dreamt about this game
before.
Like, literally, I had a dream because it's just so perfect. I've played a lot. I don't know if you played Mario Rabbids, which also has that feel.
Absolutely.
I mean, at times that feels like Gears behind cover. The gameplay and just like the world of Gears lends itself so well to that type of strategy. I just think the RNG is a little friendlier than XCOM.
Actually, Rod was talking at FanFest, and he pretty much said those words, which was, it's almost like the genre of Gears Tactics was made for Gears. Like, think about cover-based shooter, you think about different loadouts. Like, and Rod does a million times better job, and I don't want to pitch his game, but... I know the team at the Coalition is super excited about it. Really excited.
Oh, so, well, same here. Larry, we'll play.
Okay.
It's my job to get you excited about it.
I'm excited about Gears 5, but you're right. I'm not the strategy kind of guy. I love the XCOM games, but they're just not my
nightmares.
Thing.
That's fine.
Right, they're just not my thing.
When I played XCOM 2, I put you in the game.
And you killed me.
No.
Oh, I lasted.
So every time you died, I reset.
You went to you rolled the save back.
I mean, you know how that works.
I did. I actually, and this sounds really bad. I actually named my squad after my family.
No, you never did that. No,
no, but it gave me that extra incentive to be cautious and protect
them. You're never going to like bat 1,000 in a game like that. In a game with permadeath, my friends, yes. My coworkers, of course.
Yeah.
My family, it's a little bit too close.
Now, the other game that I'm excited about that we showed in our briefing was Just Cause. The next Just Cause 4. Just Cause 4. Now, I finished Just Cause 3, and I think I did all the add-ons. It looks phenomenal. I mean, this is the game. I was talking with the developers. We just saw them in person. I went up to them and I said, look, I love this game because it is the game that just says yes. Hey, can I grapple up to that helicopter? Why, yes, you can. Hey, can I strap these things here? Yes, you can. Anything you can do, you can do.
And now, tornadoes.
And now I can bring in, now I can control weather. It's like, whoa, it's crazy. So really looking forward to Just Cause 4.
Yep.
That'll be coming. I mean, look at this right here. There's Rico. Did you play any of the game, Craig? Did you play?
Yeah, I played bit of 3.
Yeah, 2 and 3, yeah.
I mean, explosions. Yeah, they do explosions.
The physics, the explosions, the jetpacks, the weapons. Look at it. Tornado.
Yeah. Dun, 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 dun. This looks really
nice. It's got a Wizard of Oz thing going.
It does. No, they were talking about they're going to have a lot of fun opportunities with the grappling hook to be able to connect things together.
Right.
Like balloons and start to make things rise up and turn anything into an aerial vehicle.
Right.
It's so funny. Like, you start off, you're on the ground, and, like, by the time you're driving around, by the time you get to the end of the game, it's like you can get there in any way.
Yeah. Oh, you're parasailing, you're jetpacking. You're bringing
on
in this.
Another chopper, you jump off of that.
I mean, it's just ridiculous, stupid, over-the-top, non-stop video game fun, which is the way it should be. One of the other ones I'm excited about that we showed quite a bit of is The Division 2.
Yes.
The Division 2 looks, we played a little bit of that when it came out.
Played quite a bit of it in New York. Well, because we recognized Lance.
Right, because we actually did an event in New York right before the game launched, and in the game, the first Division, your home base was the old post office, which we had done an event in like a month before it launched. So we're like, this is right.
And now we're going to D.C.
Now we're going to the District of Columbia, the capital of America.
That's correct. Yeah, you like pause, like, but did I get that right? They didn't move it to like,
I don't know. What's
Sacramento.
It's on fire still after this year. looking forward to The Division 2. That looks great. We'll play that.
Yeah, and what about, did you get to tell me you got to play Ori? We're actually going to play that later on.
Well, we'll talk about that.
I was just going to mention that. The Ori trailer, like, is there a more beautiful game?
Ori and the Will of the Wisps.
We're not going to talk about that on the show. We are going to talk about that later on because Jeff and I are actually going to be doing a stream of it on my channel, mixer.com/MajorNelson. We're actually going to play Ori, so you're going to get to hear more of us being silly with this beautiful, beautiful game. So, and I am told that it is quite possible. There's Kleenex in the room. Jeff may cry.
Oh, I'm a very emotional sir.
Yeah, I know you are.
I cried when I saw Gears Tactics.
So, did you cry with the new Dumbo trailer today?
I'm going to cry now.
The Dumbo live action trailer?
Dumbo depressed? No, actually, I can't watch it. I can't watch it.
Anyway. Yep. We're looking forward to that. Hey, you know what I want to do?
This looks so good.
You know what I
want to
do? I think I want to give something else away.
Do it.
So, okay.
I think you should do a video podcast, the next one, where it's just you giving stuff away and doing full on.
I don't have my microphone with me.
You need the retractable Sony, whatever it is.
Yeah, the Sony ECM50. We're going to give something else away. Grab those controllers and get ready in just a minute, because we're going to do it, okay? I have no idea what the trivia question is. The great crew here at Mixer is gonna get that ready for me in just a minute.
You have to say
wait till it comes up.
Words, don't you?
Yeah, I have to say the keywords. Okay, we're gonna say it in just a minute. But if you're watching this at home and you're watching it in beautiful 4K, did you know, you right there on your Xbox console, you can stream right to Mixer. Just hit the guide button, go over, stream to Mixer. You too can be a Mixer star. And maybe next year I will meet you, right? We'll meet you in the Mixer booth.
We'll have you over to the briefing.
Yeah, so it's a lot of fun there. So, all right, get those controllers warmed up. It's time for the next trivia question. We are going to do another 30 days of Game Pass for you, and I'll throw in 30 days of Xbox Live. All right, here is the next question. Got them ready? Controller ready? In a standard game of Scrabble, assuming you go double or triple spaces, how many points would Major Nelson score you? Scrabble.
That's
Major
hot.
Nelson.
We have a J in that.
Yeah,
so
18.
I feel like that's going to be
20,
big money.
25, 10. Dun, 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 dun. This is a tough one. I don't even know the answer to this. So, all right, time's up.
Gotta be.
Let's see what you guys at home at Mixer said it is. The correct answer is 20. Oh. How do people get that?
I think there's a 1 in 4 chance.
There is a 1 in 4 chance. Thank you,
and
math.
The J is worth like 10.
Math, it's fun. Anyway, so we'll do another one a little bit later on. So they're going to do some
hours
stuff here.
Hours flying by.
So yeah, the hour's flying by. We're here on the floor. You know what's interesting to me, Craig, is this is the second year in a row, and Jeff, this is the second year in a row where we've invited fans into Xbox, or excuse me, into E3.
This is like the fifth time. Oh, you're talking, into the expo here.
Yeah, into the expo here. So yeah. It's really got a different vibe because, we're all doing business during the day, and then 12 noon, the door.